Welcome to the Blazor DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component in a Blazor web app using Visual Studio Code. I will also show you how to populate and customize tabular data in a grid and enable a few important features like paging, sorting, filtering, and grouping. Visual Studio Code supports the .NET command line interface and the C# dev kit for building Blazor web app. In this tutorial, I will use the .NET command line interface for creating the project. Before starting, make sure you have Visual Studio Code with the latest version of the .NET SDK. All right, let's get started. With Visual Studio Code already open, I launch the terminal by pressing Control and backtick on the keyboard. After a moment, I run the command .NET new Blazor hyphen o Blazor app hyphen int server hyphen AI. This creates a new Blazor web app with server interactive rendering mode and global interactivity. Now the project has been created. Next, I navigate to the program CS file. Here, you will notice two methods, add interactive server components, which enables interactive rendering, and add interactive server render mode, which configures the server's rendering mode. Next, I navigate to the AppRaiser component. Here you can see the render mode is set to interactive server within the routes and head outlet components. To add the Syncfusion Blazor data grid component to the app, I first install the Syncfusion Blazor grid NuGet package. Before doing that, ensure you're in the project root directory of the Blazor project. Run the command .NET add package, syncfusion.blazor.grid with latest version to install the Syncfusion Blazor grid, and .NET add package, syncfusion.blazor.themes with latest version to install the Syncfusion themes. Once the installation is complete, I navigate to the imports Razor file and include the Syncfusion Blazor grid's namespace, which allows us to use the Blazor data grid component within the pages folder. Next, move to the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service in the Blazor web app. I need to reference the CSS file for the Blazor data grid component. So, I navigate to the AppRaiser component and include the CSS reference from the installed package. I have also included the necessary script reference here. Now that everything is configured, I will add the Syncfusion Blazor data grid. I open the HomeRaiser component and replace the default code with the DataGrid component. To display the DataGrid, I need to bind a data source to it. So, I create an order model with fields, like order ID, customer name, order date, and freight. Then, I define a list of orders, based on the order model class. Inside the onInitialize method, I initialize orders list with sample data containing fields, like order ID, customer name, freight, and order date. Finally, I call the toList method to materialize the collection as a list. Then, I assign the created orders data to the grid component's data source property, so the data is displayed when the component loads. I save the files, then open the terminal. Next, I run the command .NET run to start the Blazor app. Once launched, the browser will display the data grid with the provided data. To customize and display specific columns in the data grid, I add a grid columns component inside the Syncfusion grid component. Then, inside the grid columns component, I define a grid column component for each specific data field I want to display. Each grid column component represents a separate column and has properties to customize its behavior and appearance. For example, to display the order ID column, I set the field property to order ID. To customize the column header, I set the header text property to order ID. By default, text is left aligned, but I update the text align property to right. I also specify a fixed width to maintain a consistent layout. I repeat this for the other columns. I save the changes and run the application using .NET watch run command to enable hot reload. This allows the app to automatically reflect updates without restarting. You can see the customized columns. Next, I am going to display a short date format in the order date column. I set the format property to D and specify the column type as date. To show currency values in the freight column, I set the format property to C2. After making these adjustments, you can see the updated column settings in the grid. Now, let's see how to enable some important DataGrid features. I will start with paging. Paging helps manage large datasets by displaying a limited number of records per page. Instead of scrolling through many records, you can break them into smaller, more manageable pages. To enable this feature, I set the allow paging property to true. Next, the grid page settings component can be used to define paging behavior. Here I set the page size to 10 to show only 10 records in a page. I save the changes. Now, the data grid displays data in pages, making navigation easier and improving usability. Next, I will show you how to sort the records in the data grid. To do this, I set the allow sorting property to true. When sorting is enabled, I click a column header like customer name. It instantly sorts the data in ascending order. I click it again, and it switches to descending. It's easy to organize the records. Following this, I will show you how to filter the records based on input criteria. To do this, I set the allow filtering to true. For example, typing a customer name and pressing enter filters the grid to show matching records. Finally, I will enable grouping by setting the allow grouping property to true. Here, I can click and drag the customer name column header and drop it into the group area. The data grid now displays the data grouped under that column, making it easier to analyze related records. Now, let me summarize. I showed you how to add the Blazor DataGrid component to a Blazor web app using Visual Studio Code with .NET command line interface. Also, I showed how to bind a data source, customize columns, and enable features like paging, sorting, filtering, and grouping. For more information on the DataGrid features, check out the documentation link in the description below. If you would like to explore the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link. I have also provided a link where you can check if you qualify for a free community license to access all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.